नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज पोर्ट टाउन्स. लॉन्ग कोस्टल ऑफ द कंट्री एंड इट्स एक्सटेंसिव ट्रेड विद द आउटसाइड वर्ल्ड एनकरेज द राइज ऑफ मेनी पोर्ट टाउन्स. सो एज देर वॉज अ लॉन्ग कोस्ट लाइन ऑफ द कंट्री दैट इज आवर कंट्री एंड ड्यू टू इट्स यू कैन से द ट्रेड सिस्टम विच वॉज आउटसाइड द इंडिया इट एनकरेज टू इंक्रीज द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ मेनी पोर्ट टाउन्स. कैम्बे, सुपारा, बरौच, सूरत एंड गोवा वेर लोकेटेड ऑन द वेस्टर्न कोस्ट वाइल तमरालीप्टी एंड मुसलीपट्टनम वेर इम्पॉर्टेंट पोर्ट्स ऑन द ईस्टर्न कोस्ट. दीज पोर्ट फैसिलिटेट इंडिया स्ट्रेट विद अफ्रीका, वेस्ट एशिया, यूरोप एंड साउथ ईस्ट एशिया. सो दीज आर द वेरियस कंट्रीज थ्रू विच इंडिया हैड अ ट्रेड सिस्टम. In this picture, you can see Surat in the medieval period. So, in this is the scenario how the different types of items were exported and imported to different parts of the country. Founded towns. Occasionally, new capital cities were founded if the existing one became overcrowded. So, occasionally, new capital cities were founded because the previous one was overcrowded. In the 16th century, Sultan Muhammad Quli Qutb Shah founded the city of Hyderabad. So he is the person who founded the city of Hyderabad. Remember the name, as Golconda had become too congested. So as the Golconda was become too congested, that means overcrowded, due to which he established a new city, that is Hyderabad. Akbar founded Fatehpur Sikri to mark his victory after conquering of Gujarat. So after he conquered the Gujarat and added to his territory, Akbar founded a new city known as Fatehpur Sikri. As an expression of Mughal authority and sovereignty, the city of Sahajanabad was founded. So as we can say, in order to show the Mughal authority and the power, a new city was founded. It was the Sahajanabad. It comprised the Jama Masjid, Red Fort, White Roads, bazaars, as well as administrative centers of the Mughal dynasty. So in the Sahajanabad, Jama Masjid was constructed. Even the Red Fort was also constructed. The roads was wide. Bazaar was also there, and as well as administrative centers were set up in order to run the Mughal Empire. This is the picture of Fatehpur Sikri near Agra. Is home to a number of monuments and structures built during the reign of Akbar. So this is a city which was founded by the Akbar. A close look at three cities. Hampi. A grand capital city, Hampi, is located on the banks of river Tungabhadra in northern Karnataka. The name Hampi is an anglicized version of the Kannada word Hempe, derived from Pampa, the ancient name of river Tungabhadra. So the name Hampi, the meaning of the word Hampi is river Tungabhadra in the ancient time. Okay, so it was you can say the Hampi was originated from a Kannada word which is known as Hampi, which was derived from a Pampa, which was the ancient name of river Tungabhadra, because this city is situated near the river Tungabhadra. Hampi stands among the ruins of Vijayanagara, the former capital of Vijayanagara Empire in northern Karnataka. So Hampi, it stand when the Vijayanagara Empire was destroyed. Okay, and it was the former capital of Vijayanagara Empire, especially in the northern Karnataka. It is also referred to as Vishakapura after the names of the patron deity of Vijayanagara ruler Vishakapaksha. So this city was also known as Vishakapura after the Vijayanagara ruler's name, that is the Vishakapaksha, which was the Virupaksha. The empire was founded by the Telugu prince Harihara and Bukka in 1336 CE. So who had founded the Hampi? It was the The empire, that means the Vijayanagara Empire, was founded by the Telugu princes, that is Harihara and Bukka, in the year 1336 CE. It reached the height of its glory under Krishna Deva Raya. So during the Krishna Deva Raya period, this empire reached at its glory, that means at the high level. Hampi was chosen as the capital due to its strategic location, bounded by the river Tungabhadra on one side and the defensive hills on the other side. So during the Vijayanagara period, Hampi was chosen as the capital. Why? Because of its location. In one side it was surrounded by river Tungabhadra, and on the other side the defensive hills, that is mountains, were present. So this is the remains of Hampi. Foreign travelers like Niccolo Conti from Italy, Abdur Razak from Persia, and Domingo Pires from Portugal visited Vijayanagara and described the city as well fortified with a distinctive architecture. So these are the famous foreign travelers who visited during the Vijayanagara period, and they have described the various architectures and monuments which were constructed during the Vijayanagara period. The buildings has splendid arches, domes and pillared halls. So the buildings, it were many arches were there, even the domes were present, which is a signature architecture style of Mughals, and pillared halls, well-planned orchards and pleasure gardens where sculptural motifs such as the lotus were also built. So there was a well-planned orchards, the garden system, and the garden was you can say surrounded by lotus. The account of Domingo Pius, who visited the court of Krishna Deva Raya, is particularly unique as it provides a vivid account of the Vijayanagara Empire. So with the help of Domingo Pius, we come to know that during the Krishna Deva Raya, Vijayanagara Empire was the structure of the monuments was quite different from the other emperor, and it plays an important role in order to increase the glory of the Vijayanagara Empire.